Hey, what's up, folks? Folkettes, YouTubians. I'm Darren, Small Town Preparedness. Welcome to STP Chat. Every now and then, you know, this is a new channel. So every now and then, we're going to have these STP Chats. Just bringing up some subjects of thought. Today's thought is going to be, what are you preparing for? Some people, are prepping for, an economic collapse, a nuclear disaster, EMP, flood, whatever it may be, okay? One thing that I'll never forget is I think the biggest reason why I prep, and I want to tell you about it. It's kind of a little story here. It happened on May 31st, 1985. A huge EF5 tornado came barreling through my backyard. You actually can see this video, I think even on YouTube still, because somebody was videotaping a dance recital, and then they seen that the tornado was going on outside, so they started videotaping that. But about 20 minutes before the tornado came through, I was outside, and this is before lawn darts were banned. I was actually throwing lawn darts up in the air and running away from them, trying to avoid being hit by them. That was my game back in the day. Of course, I was an only child. I didn't have anybody to play with. But I went inside. Well, the one thing I remember about outside when I was playing with the lawn darts is it was extremely calm outside. It was extremely calm. There was almost like a green haze in the sky. I had went inside, and I can't remember what for. I mean, this was a really, really long time ago. But my mom was looking out the window, and she asked my grandpa, her father, hey, Dad, why are these tires flying around in the backyard? And in typical grandpa fashion, he yelled at my mother, saying, those tires aren't flying around, you idiot. That's a tornado. Everybody in the basement. He screamed that out to everybody, and, the whole family was there that day. The whole family ran downstairs into the basement. And I remember, I was 4 years old. I had like this kung fu death grip on my mom's leg. I was just so petrified. But it's kind of funny though, because after that, I became fascinated with the weather. So much, that's what I pursued as my education in college. But that's another story for another day. Anyways, this tornado, it was just shaking everything. It probably felt worse than any earthquake a Californian may have ever felt. I remember people downstairs in the basement, they were crying. My mother was praying. There were things flying from the top of the stairs, coming down into the basement. Glass and stuff like that was flying downstairs, down the stairs and all. And when we were able to come back up, and went outside, it was complete, utter carnage. Our house, luckily, our house was the only one left standing. Lucky for us, it was still there. But my dad, my grandpa, my dad and my uncle started running around the neighborhood because our neighbors were in their basements and they needed help. They started, pulling people out of the rubble, stuff like that, hoping that nobody had died. I think that only maybe 5 or 6 people had died in that disaster, which luckily, that's all it was, because it could have been a whole lot worse. But I remember that the power was out after that for about a week. We didn't have any water for about a week and a half. I was 4 years old. There's obviously nothing I really could do about it at the time. But you know, my family, well, my grandpa was a prepper. Nobody else in my family was, you know. So that, I think, is the ultimate reason on why I became a prepper. Because if I'm pushed into that type of scenario again, you know, I never want to have to worry. I don't want my family to have to worry. You know, I want to make sure that there's food and water and necessities that you need for survival. But that's probably one of the worst memories I have as a kid growing up. And then just more recently, I'm a firefighter and emergency medical technician for a living. And in my jurisdiction, maybe a couple weeks ago now, a huge, huge storm, 60 mile per hour plus winds were roaring through, you know, the community I serve. And we ended up getting call after call, wires and trees down. And then we ended up running mutual aid to a neighboring community for a tree that fell on a house that went through the roof. Water was pouring into the house and there were children inside. Luckily, you know, God willing, everybody was okay. But think about that. You know, think about, what are you going to do in that situation? What if you're the mother or the father? You know what I mean? What if you don't have money to go put your family up in a hotel? Are you going to stay in your house that has a huge hole in the roof? You know, with water pouring in and potentially electrical dangers and stuff like that. Because we actually couldn't even get to the house in our fire apparatus. There were wires and trees down all over the road on both sides. The only way we could get there was by foot. So everybody had to walk to the scene. We couldn't even respond, like I said, in an apparatus. So it was, you know, pretty scary for the family. The kids were really upset. But ultimately, like I said, you know, everybody was okay. But the biggest thing is, what I want to know is, you know, what do you prepare for? What is your emergency that you're worried about the most? Me, it's a little bit of everything. But I think more so natural disasters. But however, I'm not going to completely ignore the possibility of an economic collapse. You know, you have to keep all that stuff in mind as well. That's what a smart prepper does. There's some people who will prep for just one specific thing. But then the problem is with most people's luck, if you are prepping for a nuclear war, you're going to get an EMP. So then it's like, well, now what? You know, now what do I do? So if you try to prepare for a little bit of everything, you increase your chances of survival greatly. You know, trying to prep for a little bit of everything, making sure you have food, water, you know, alternate, you know, sources of power. What if you can't stay in your home? You know, what if a huge tree decided to, you know, take over your couch? You know, do you have a good shelter, you know, for a bug out situation? You know, I mean, what is it that you guys are preparing for? Or can you tell me what your memory was, or if anything stuck in your head memory-wise, on why you prep? There's a few people that I've talked to. They are military folks. I have never been in the military. I would love the opportunity to actually be in the Army Reserve, well, the National Guard. They will accept people my age. I would love to do that. But I'd have to cut down some weight, you know, before I could do something like that. I have nothing but respect for, you know, our veterans, current military personnel, first responders. You know, I am a first responder myself. But what was your trigger? You know, why do you prepare? You know, another thing that I wanted to bring up. I watch a lot of YouTube channels, and there are a ton of awesome awesome channels out there. And I could probably list off 15 awesome channels that I think that you guys would benefit from greatly. But there's some channels, I'm just going to call them clickbait. That's all they are, is clickbait. You know, like these ones, oh, civil war imminent, civil war comes tomorrow. You know, economic collapse confirmed. All this crazy stuff. You know what I mean? It's clickbait to get you to watch, so that increases their numbers on their YouTube channel. I am not cool with that. Now, other people, they may think that's okay, you know. To me, I kind of view it as a survival prepping for normal people's Wacky Wednesday. If you ever get a chance, check out Kyle with Survival Prepping for Normal People. Recently, he did stop publishing videos on YouTube. He's running strictly on Patreon now because he's not very pleased with the way YouTube is doing things right now, along with a lot of other people. Me, I'm too new for it to have any direct effect on me at this point. But you have to watch out for some of these channels. There's a lot of these channels, you know, it's huge, massive clickbait. And then after that, of course, once they ruffle your feathers, what do they try to do? They try to sell you something. You know, these are the type of channels that you got to watch out for. Because they're out for one thing, your money. You know, and you need to invest your money in your preps. You don't need to make some dude, you know, some rich dude richer. You know, don't make his Lamborghini payment or his Corvette payment. That is not why you were put on this earth. You were put on this earth to be self-sufficient. You know, don't give to somebody like that. Now, mind you, it's always good to give. But to people who need it. Not to people who don't need it. There is one, actually, speaking of that, there's another channel that comes up to mind with that one. And it's Step One Survival with Staff Sergeant BA. Awesome, awesome channel. He's a, Marine veteran. Really, really smart. Great guy to talk to. Every Friday, actually, what he does is he goes to his church. And normally it's like pasta or something like that that they make to feed less fortunate people. And those, in my opinion, are the type of people you should be trying to reach out to and trying to help. The people who really need it. But, clickbait, really, guys, watch out for it. Because they're just out to get you. I've been trying to think of a third subject, really, that I wanted to touch base with you on today. And I was kind of struggling with it. Kind of struggling with a third topic that I really wanted to hit base with you guys on today. I'm tired. I'm dead tired. I work 5 jobs. I'm actually on my way home from work now. Just most of my videos that you'll probably see are going to be me sitting in this car seat, driving home or driving to work or something like that. I have about a 2-hour drive to get home from one of my jobs. One of my jobs, I'm medical for a racetrack. And so it's a long weekend. It was a pretty long weekend, but it's always fun, you know, when you're working the racetrack. Anyways, you know what? I think that's all I really got for you guys today. I want to appreciate your time. We're going to be having a giveaway here very soon. I want to try to, you know, get a few more people on the channel. We're probably going to have this giveaway contest. What I'm thinking I'm going to do, I'm not sure what I'm giving away yet. That will be announced here probably within the next day or two. But, you know, the way it's going to go is everybody, you know, that is going to be eligible for this giveaway is going to have to, you know, like the video, comment, you know, make sure they're subscribed, of course. They have to subscribe and share the video. share the video with your friends. You know, get some people on the STP train. That's what I'm going to call it. The small town preparedness train. Let's build a universe, guys. Let's build an STP universe. I want to build a community on this page, you know, on this channel. There's so many great communities, and I want to have another one built here, you know, and hopefully, you know, I'd like to do some collaborative videos, you know, with some other YouTube channel makers here in the future, because there's so many smart people out there that you guys can absorb from. And I think it's just a great educational and learning experience, you know, not just for me, but for you guys too. You know, I've been a prepper now for about 6-7 years, but I don't know everything. And I think it'd be foolish if somebody claimed that they did. But with all that said, I think I'm going to go ahead and get off here, because I'm going to be home in probably, I'd say maybe about 10 minutes or so. So it'll be nice to go home, kick my feet up on the recliner, relax, you know, and try to just enjoy the rest of the night. And it's Sunday, you know, I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day too. Hopefully you had the chance to get a little worship in today, you know, go to church if you're religious, and enjoy time with friends and family. So guys, thank you, and thank you for joining me for STP Chat. Small Town Preparedness out. Take care.